Okay. Hopefully we won't have, I was going to say, too many interruptions from the roosters. But I'm going to talk a little bit about what is a so-called solar generator. And I used to be like so interested in what they called solar generators and thought I wanted to buy one. All right, guys, enough. And then after doing a little research and doing this little project, and that's what this is. This is a project that I'm about to show you, okay? So it was a learning process, basically. And after I did this, then I realized that a solar generator is not what a lot of people actually think it is. Because when we think of a generator, we think, you know, you put gas in it, you pull it, and it runs. And it's rated for X amount of watts. Okay? Well, with a solar generator, they actually sell it based upon the fact that it, like, they might sell it as a 1500 watt solar generator, okay? The battery might only be 100 amp hours at the most, not even that usually. I mean, they're usually like 40, 50 amp hours. And then the solar panel might only be 40, 50, 60 watts, right? And so you think, oh, 1500 watts, how do they get that? Well, because there's a 1500 watt inverter built into the system, and that's how they get the 1500 watt rating on it. Well, that's kind of misleading as far as I'm concerned. So I was like, you know, if it's going to be 1500 watts, then yeah, it would run 1500 watts, but for how long? And there's a whole math process, and I'm not going to do that and get into that, because there's plenty of places where you can get into that. So anyway, I built this little project just to see what would be involved so that I can, you know, perhaps do another one. And this one I built specifically to go with my Yaesu 897, FD897 ham radio, okay? So it'll run that and it'll charge laptops and phones and stuff. It's not a real big system, but it's enough for what I need it to be, okay? And it's still portable. I can lift it, which is a big thing. That's what I wanted, something that I could pick up and lift and take with me if I wanted to or if I needed to. Now, this is not as portable as some of the smaller systems that you'll see for radios, but again, I wanted this to be a little bit dual purpose. So basically, what I did is I bought this. It was called a power center box. The box itself was empty. It had no battery in it. Okay? It had no battery in it, and it had an Atwood power box here, basically a battery checker. Pressed it and you could see if your battery was charged or not. And then also it had the outside posts. And I don't know if we can see that. So much sun out here. It had the outside posts. Okay, and let me see, get it in a good position here. And there, the outside post, and two cigarette lighters, okay? And it also had heavy gauge battery cables already connected, okay? So that was a major plus for me, because, yeah, I could have put it in another box, but this one, I found it on clearance at Walmart. So I was like, well, it kind of give me a jump start, and then I can kind of play with how I want to do the rest of it. So basically that's what I did. And then I bought a 35 amp hour battery to go inside here. And I bought which the battery cost me $87. I want to say about $87.89. I can't remember exactly. And then I bought a charge controller, and this is just one of those Harbor Freight charge controllers. I actually got it off of eBay for $27, including shipping. So that was a pretty good deal. And it's rated 500 watts, but if you look at it, it's rated actually for 25 volts, I believe it is. So you got to kind of keep an eye on that too. And let's see. I made cables that go on here and the Anderson pole connectors. And the reason why I did that is because I wanted to make it more flexible. I wanted to allow for things to be kind of plug and play. And I don't have any big panels right now. We have a Harbor Freight set, like you know, but I don't have any big panels at the moment. Okay, so what I was talking about with the Anderson pole connectors, I have one leading from the solar panel connection. And I did a little conversion there. I added an Anderson pole onto one end, and the other end, I think they call them an SCA connector. The other end has an SCA connector, okay? And that is going in to the charge controller from the solar panel. And you'll see solar panels. And these are solar briefcases, so again, not gonna get a lot off of them. They're like 13 watts each. Okay, so on the wiring, it's the heavy gauge wiring going from the posts in the front, to the battery. And then you'll see I have multiple cables running off of the battery. Then I have an Anderson pole connector connected directly to the battery. And then I have another Anderson pole connector that runs into the charge controller. Okay, the charge controller I just have mounted up here with two screws, and I've got it so that I can actually put it off. It's really just hanging on the two screws. It's not mounted because I wanted the ability to take it off if I needed to. So one set of wires is coming from the charge controller to the battery. One set of wires is coming from the charge controller to the solar panel right here. And again, I added an Anderson pole connector on there, which I didn't have to. I could put another one in there that just has an SCA connector, but I just wanted some options there. And then we also have one coming from what is called the load connection on the charge controller that goes directly out into the front. Okay, so that's how it's wired inside. And the two cigarette lighters on the box have 10 amp fuses wired into them. All right. And here's the Anderson pole connectors in the front. And I have covers on them to kind of help keep them waterproof a little bit there. And this one has a B on it, just handwritten for battery. And again, this is just a little test I made. And then this one has C for charge controller. So it'll go directly from the solar panel through the charge controller and out here. It is bypassing the battery is what it's doing. And say there's not enough sun or if it's evening, then I can go directly through the battery and run. So again, nice little options, okay? 35 amp hours, it's not a big system, okay? But it'll run my radio on QRP for a pretty good amount of time. I probably get, if I'm running it low, I haven't actually tested it, but by the figures, I would get probably 30 hours off of it. Depends on how many watts I run my radio at, and again, how much I'm talking and how much I'm receiving compared to how much I'm talking. I'm more of a listener usually than I am a talker, so again, but right now, I just use it for little things like running my water pump, like I did my water transfer pump in the morning, which I'm going to make a whole separate one just for my water transfer pump and make it mobile on wheels so I can move it from one water barrel to another. Whole nother story. And then I also run these little fans, okay? And these DC fans, I bought this at Tractor Supply, and it comes with a DC connector for a cigarette lighter connector. Well, so I can run it directly in here, but that would be running off of my battery instead of off of my panels, okay? So the question would be is right now, are those panels taking in enough sun? And I have four. Okay, so if I wanted to run the fan directly from the solar panels, it would be dependent on, are those fans, which it doesn't take much, or are those solar panels taking in enough voltage watts to run that little fan. I have a 5-watt and a 5-watt and a 13-watt and a 13-watt, and yes, that one's cracked, but it still puts out the full wattage, and got it at a really good price off of someone because it was broken, but it's still wattage, I should say. It still puts out the regular amounts. It's just not moisture waterproof right now as it stands, okay? But so I've got the far one that I'm showing you now, I got at Harbor Freight for, with the coupon and everything, came to $56. And it's 13 watts, like I said, and it's 12 or 24 volts. And then this one is the same thing, came from a different place though. And like I said, it came from a friend of ours. And I'm not sure exactly how much he paid for it, but I think his actually came with a little charge controller too. And then the 2 5-watts I got on sale at Cabela's, I use them for trickle charging for like, we don't drive the truck a lot. We only use it when we're making trips or need to haul something. So I use that to keep my battery trickle charged on the big truck. So I've got 4 wires from 4 separate panels coming into 1 splitter, okay? This splitter allows me to run 4 panels for a total watts of 325 watts, and it runs them into a single. So they are running in series, from how I understand the electronics of it works. They're running in series through the single SEA connector and into where I made. And again, you know, the weak point here is the small wiring. You're going to have more loss on DC from the small wiring than from anything else, okay? And that's one of the reasons why I opted not to use an inverter. And that's one of the reasons why I opted not to use an inverter is because I didn't want the losses from the inverter. I have losses from small wiring already because that's the way this stuff comes. And I really didn't want, and it's not going to be real great because again, there's not a whole lot coming in on such a little system. But if I was making a bigger system, it could be an issue. So with the inverter, I decided I have one. If we need it, I can connect it up to those external posts, and I can even make it so that it connects directly into one of my Anderson power poles. But again, probably won't use it unless I absolutely have to. We have DC adapters, battery chargers for our laptops. We have them for our DVD player, you know, all the important stuff in life when you go somewhere, right? And the fans, we got DC powered fans. And so there's not a whole lot really that I could say that, and you know, our ham radios obviously are also DC. Okay, and I digressed off of the fan that I had originally and switched over, started talking about the solar panels. But the fan, which is, like I said, a little DC fan, I picked up at Tractor Supply on sale. It was like $9. And I gotta say, this little booger puts out some air, so I can connect it directly into one of the outlets here. And let's see if I can do this one-handed. I can connect it directly into the cigarette lighter plug here, and voila, there it goes. Very nice. Okay, and I have run it all day off of the battery with the solar panels plugged in, and no loss, no drain on the battery because it's just not using enough. Okay, but now let's say it's a nice, beautiful, sunny day, and I want to run this fan directly off of the solar panels and not off of the battery. So what I would do is, I have 2 adapters here. Okay. One, I switched and put Anderson pole connectors on them. And this adapts from my Anderson pole connector to my cigarette lighter adapter. Okay. So basically it's just going to bypass that and run direct from the solar. Now, if I'm going to do that, there is a little switch in here that I have to press, and you'll see it's showing that the battery is at 13.7 volts. But if I want to use the load, then I must press the little load button and it turns it on and off basically. And you can use that for lights also, okay? So let's hook everything up. Okay, got that. And let me plug the fan in. Okay, so fan is plugged in, power pole right there. Let's see if it'll work. Now we're up to 13.9 volts. And voila, we pressed the button and now we have bypassed the battery and are working directly off of the solar panel. And what you'll see is instead of the extra volts coming in to my battery, it dropped down because now 0.3 volts is being used for the fan, apparently, roughly, I guess. I'm not real good at the volts and stuff. I worked with it some and I'm learning as I'm going, but definitely this project has made a lot of things clear that I previously did not understand. So that's just something small, but I have two DC lights that I can run off of it for emergency lighting. Again, I can run my radio off of it. And let's see, if we press the button here, it'll show we're bringing in 0.8 amps right now. Oops. So, 0.9 amps. And we're using 0.8 amps. Okay, so we're bringing in basically exactly what we're using. So we have no loss. Okay, yeah, 8 amps coming in, 0.8 amps coming in, and 0.8 amps going out. So no loss. So not too bad. If, you know, free energy. If it was hot outside or if it was hot inside, nice long cord, I usually keep this battery actually right inside the entryway door on the side where it's kind of not seen, kind of doesn't get in the way. But at the same time, it's easy to plug stuff into it if I need it, and it's right there, and I can still have the cables running out in the front with the solar panels to charge everything. So that is my small example of a solar generator, okay? And the thing is to make sure when I unplug this, I'm gonna wanna make sure and turn the load off inside, because we don't want just an open load basically. And I cap them so it wouldn't be so bad, but still, okay? And again, the battery box is nice, but you could use a battery box that wasn't pre-wired for all the extra meters. And this meter, I really wouldn't need, because the charge controller I have shows the, you know, how many amps I have on the battery and stuff. But if you get one of the smaller charge controllers that doesn't have a meter to show you, it's kind of nice just at the press of a touch on the outside to have it. And again, at the time when I bought the box, I wasn't quite sure how it was going to do it. I just figured it'd be a good jump start. But a friend of ours built one using a toolbox, and he did a really awesome job on it. So hopefully sometime soon I'll be able to get him to bring his little box so we can do a video on his. And he did a really, really great example of a very portable little box. And on these connectors, I have a variety of them, and I just keep a little empty plastic box. I'll probably get a better box for it, but this one was handy at the time. And I keep an assortment of these. And again, I have two of these because I have two of the little briefcase solar panels and they come with them. And I changed the ends. Okay. And then I have one of these just because then I have where I can hook something directly in that I don't have a power pole on, perhaps. And I don't have clamps or anything. Then we have a regular car lighter adapter with the SEA, and several of the alligator clips. And you'll see again, these both of these alligator clips have the SEA, and they come with all the solar panels and another cigarette lighter plug and another alligator clip. So, and I have one in another box that I keep my radio stuff in that actually has Anderson power poles that I put on them. Just again, some options. This little thing here is actually came with it. It's for a Harbor Freight drill, and the drill is only like $19 on sale. And since we have the free charger for the solar panel, I figured, well, you know, we'll pick one up, because surprisingly they have decent ratings. But again, a whole nother video. So if you have any questions, I will answer certainly what I can. And again, I did this as a learning experience to use with my radio for backup power for my radio, my ham radio. And we'll go from there. I'm probably, again, going to build another one. I did another video on my water pump here, my Wayne PC1 water pump. And so I'll build a little portable solar generator for that. But that's really all a solar generator is. If I pop an inverter, and I have a 750-watt inverter, if I popped a 750-watt inverter in that box and cut the little holes out so it would fit in there, this would be considered a 750-watt. Well, the charge controller wouldn't handle it, but if I had a bigger charge controller, or as it is right now, with this charge controller, a 500-watt charge controller, if I put a 400-watt or 450-watt inverter on here, I would have a 450-watt solar generator. Okay, so a little bit misleading, because again, the battery is only 35 amp hours, and that's going to determine how much I'm going to run off of that battery, and my charge controller is going to determine how much I can run off of there, and my panels are going to determine how long it takes to recharge my battery. And I've never run it down yet, but that's probably something I'll have to test next, to run it down to the point that the charge controller, because your charge controller is going to control overcharging from the sun panels, from the solar panels, and it's going to prevent discharge at night. If I would leave these hooked up at night, it will prevent back drain basically to the solar panels from the battery in the evening. Okay, and it also will prevent overcharging of your product if you, whatever you hook in through your charge controller. So it's just a little protection there, which is really nice to have. So for a little starter system, this is great. I'm gonna get everything packed up. If you have any questions, I'll answer what I can. I'm not an expert, still learning in this, and you know, I bet you a lot of you have some great ideas that you're willing to share, and I'm always happy to be open to suggestions also. So that would really be great. I'd appreciate any suggestions also. And I'll probably be very soon getting a larger, getting some larger solar panels, etc. But that's a whole nother thing. Like I said, the point of this one is portability. Okay, so everything fits nicely back into my little box here. And I have room here on the side. I just put some padding in there. So now that I cut off the fan, you'll see it's 13.9 volts again. So this box fits nicely in there. And I just keep a little pack of Anderson pole connectors, little electrical connectors and stuff. You never know when you're going to have to make a quick fix. It's always better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. So I prefer to always have it and not need it.